How to use Google Meet on iPad. I will show you how to install the app, how to join a meeting, how to create a meeting. Let's get started. Let's see how to install Google Meet on iPad. First, we need to go to the App Store, so open App Store. On the search, write Google Meet. Now, tap on search. After you have found the app, just tap on get and wait. It will ask you your password or your fingerprint. Complete the requirements. You have installed Google Meet on your iPad. After the install is complete, just tap on open. Tap on continue. Here, tap allow Meet to access the camera. Also, allow Meet to access the microphone. Let's tap sign in. I will set up a new Gmail account, but you can log in with an existing one. Tap on add another account. Tap here continue. Here you can log in with your current email if you do not wish to create a Gmail account. Tap on create an account. I will select for myself. Write the first name and the last name. Tap next. Write the birthday and gender. Tap next. Pick the best Gmail account that you like. Tap next. Here, write the password and confirm the password. Then, tap next. Here, tap yes, I am. Now, tap next. Agree with terms of service and tap create an account. Tap confirm. Now you are connected with an account on Google Meet. You can now join a meeting or create a new meeting. Also, directly on this screen, you can mute the microphone and turn off the camera. If the buttons from the bottom are red, then it means your microphone and camera are off. On the right, you have the audio option. You can select any device that is connected to your iPad. On the left menu, you have settings. But mostly this is empty now. Probably Google will add more settings shortly. How to join a meeting on Google Meet for iPad? You will need to have the ID of the session. Find this info from the person who creates the meeting. Tap on meeting code. Now, write here the ID of the meeting. Tap on join meeting. Please note, if you have multiple Google accounts, you can also switch to another account here. Also, you can turn off the microphone or turn off the camera if you want before you join. Maybe, if you are not correctly dressed or you wish not to be in an awkward situation, do the setting directly here. Here, tap ask to join. Wait until the host permits you to enter the meeting. We are in the meeting now. You will see the microphone and camera button. You can turn off or turn on. If the camera and microphone are red, then it means they are off. We will have here also the leave button. At the meeting, we have People tab, Chat tab, and Info tab. On the People tab, we will see the list of participants. If you tap on somebody's picture, you will pin that person, and you will see it live. You can also choose yourself to pin. On the chat, we will be able to talk with the participants with text. On the Info tab, we will find the info about the meeting and have the possibility to invite somebody else. The three dots menu will allow you to switch the camera and also share the screen of your iPad. On the top, we have the audio option and also the captition option. You can turn the captation on so you see what people say. This is very good when you do not hear the meeting. Now, if you wish to leave the meeting, just tap on this button. How to create a meeting on Google Meet for iPad? You can turn off the microphone or turn off the camera before you create the meeting. For you to create a simple meeting, just tap on the New Meeting button. When you get into the meeting, you will get the option to share the session. You can share this link with others or simply share this ID. The ID of the conference is the last part of the link. You will be able to share this link on the apps of your iPad. So, it will be easy to share it on any social media that you have on your iPad. We are in the meeting now. Let's see how this looks when somebody joins the meeting. Tap on Admit to allow that person. Also, you can deny entry to somebody you do not know. Let's tap on the People tab. You see here the new person who joined. If you tap on somebody's picture, you will pin that person, and you will see it live bigger. You can also choose yourself to see bigger. Also, you have here an arrow that will allow you to do some stuff like turn off audio, which does not work now, but probably will do so in the future, and also remove that person from the meeting. This is quite useful. Now, if you wish to leave the meeting, just tap on this button. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.